schools will be opened after the weekend, area-wise, so that children's studies do not suffer. As movement restrictions are removed, area by area, movement of public transport will be allowed in these areas. Government offices have been made fully functional from today, and the attendance in many offices is quite high. Telecom connectivity, which has been a point of sore concern, will gradually be eased and restored in a phased manner, keeping in mind the constant threat posed by terrorist organizations in using mobile connectivity to organize terror actions. Preventive detentions are being continuously reviewed, and appropriate decisions will be made based on law and order assessments. It is expected that over the next few days, as the restrictions get eased, life in Jammu and Kashmir will become completely normal. The intent of terrorist attacks was to create an atmosphere of fear and terror and to block development that could unleash opportunities for the younger generation of people in the state. Among the groups that are well known for sponsoring violence and carrying out such attacks are Lashkar-e-Toiba, Jaish-e-Mohammed, Hizbul Mujahideen, etc. In implementing the decisions taken last fortnight, this history of cross-border terrorism required the government to put in place certain preventive steps as a precautionary measure. Steps consequently taken included restrictions on free movement, prevention of large gatherings, restrictions on telecom connectivity, and closure of schools and colleges. A few preventive detentions of individuals were also made in accordance with the provision of law to maintain law and order and avoid breach of peace. 12 of the 22 districts are functioning normally with some limited restrictions in 5 of these. The measures put in place have ensured that there has been not a single loss of life. I repeat, there has not been a single loss of life or serious injuries to anyone during the course of maintaining peace and order.
The communication lines will be restored. Of course, they will be done as we have been talking. In fact, 3 days ago, we had reported that post the 15th of August, the administration is going to review on whether these phone lines and communication lines will be open or not. I think that review meeting has been done, and it has been decided that in a phased manner over the weekend, gradually from landlines to mobile phones, the restoration process is going to begin. We believe that the state communications platform, the Bharat Sanchar Nigam Limited, BSNL, is going to take time till this evening. It takes a couple of hours for the lines to fully restore. That process, we were told by the Chief Secretary, is going to continue. So the biggest relief for the people in the valley is that the communication lines will be open and fully operational by the end of the weekend. Apart from that, a number of crucial decisions that were announced. One of them being the schools will open on Monday, which we broke right here on NDTV. Public transport is going to be allowed for the people starting Monday. Telecom connectivity we have already reported. And preventive detentions are going to be reviewed, which means all those people who have been kept under preventive detention, there could be a review, and subsequently, post the threat assessment, they could be released as well. So I think this is an important step towards attaining normalcy in the valley, which many people were talking about. He also mentioned the organizations of the group sponsoring violence as well as terrorism in the valley, which is a list that everybody knows, Lashkar-e-Toiba, Jaish-e-Mohammed, as well as Hizbul Mujahideen. They said that they had credible intelligence that they will try to create trouble in the valley, and that is why certain steps had to be taken. Add to that the decision that the government had taken about the abrogation of 370. So the use of the word precautionary was deliberate and used a number of times in the address. So now what we are hearing is that most of these rules are going to be relaxed in a phased manner. There will be prolonged relaxation is from what we are understanding over the weekend. That means right now if there is restriction in the movement of traffic in downtown areas, completely and the rest of the city is normal, then for a restriction in normally across the valley is going to be eased, and then over the weekend the security as well as the clampdown in the downtown area of Srinagar, which is the most volatile, will also be put under review, which means that they will open for a period and then assess how things are going on, and then eventually decide how to take it forward from there. So I think this is the same drill that is usually followed by the administration. A valley which has been hit by terror on a number of occasions, 2008, 2010 and 2016 were mentioned by the chief secretary, and we have seen how bloody it actually got in the valley. Given that there should not be a repeat of that, most of these steps that were taken this time around were all precautionary, well in advance. And then the easing of these steps are going to take place. So this, I believe, is a very, very significant step that the administration has taken. However, there is a rider over here that local administration in the various districts of Kashmir have been given the authority to continue the restrictions for as long as they want if they feel that the assessment is otherwise, and the assessment gives a picture that these restrictions must remain for longer. So that right has been given to the local administration. But largely, we can expect that peace and normalcy, or at least normalcy, could in fact return by the within Saturday as well as Sunday.